Hi guys, welcome to today's video. Today's video is very special. In fact, we have a special guest, Anna Feltraco. She's a knowledge engineer here at Wonderflow, and she will guide us through the world of text analysis, explaining how we can train the machines to perform top-class data analysis. So from now on, you won't see me anymore on this screen.
Hello, my name is Anna, and I'm a linguistic expert at Wonderflow. Today, we will address the use of machines in the linguistic analysis field, especially when we have to handle a big number of comments. Let's imagine that you have a big number of comments, and let's imagine you want to understand if in such comments, people is talking about the design of your product and what they think about that design. The easiest way will be to search for relevant keywords in such comments. For example, you may want to look for beautiful or pretty. We did an internal test, and in less than a minute, a machine were able to detect where these two words are located in 5 million of comments. That means many millions of words. And we bet the machine did not miss any of them. In the same span of time, my colleagues were able to read just few comments. No doubt, machines are much faster and more consistent. But notice, the machine also retrieved these cases. I bought it for my beautiful sister. The price is pretty expensive. And here we are no longer talking about the design. So the machine also retrieved these bad examples. We can improve these results. For example, we can use a statistical approach in which first, we distinguish this example from those examples. Then we feed the machine with a lot of these examples. And finally, we ask the machine to predict if a new expression fits in this group or in that group. Possibly, the machine will predict that if the word beautiful is in the same context of the word baby, then the expression will fit in this group. Another strategy consists in instructing the machine to make a decision according to predefined conditions. Each of these conditions need to be provided singularly to the machine. For example, we can instruct the machine that those examples are not good for the design topic. This approach relies less on probability, but requires much more effort on the part of humans. Well, I just described two different approaches. Now it's up to you to select which one suits you better. The first one is faster, but with the second one, you can reach higher level of precision.
Guys, I really hope you like this video made with our special guest, Anna. If you didn't subscribe to my channel, you really have to do it right now. See you next time.